agreed to wear to a meeting or in the office, and I still think it's really cute and kind of sexy. I never underestimate the power of a tight little turtleneck. And this one is secondhand, but it's by the brand Brandy Melville. It's so warm. There is an oil stain on it, which I will cover with this bag and my hand at the same time. This bag, though, I got in Paris. I love the shape of it. I love the material. It's kind of shiny, and it's just a really nice size. I love the little gold hardware on it. Kind of ties in with my earrings and the belt. This belt is secondhand from my friend Nia. I used it to cinch in these ethically made high-waisted trousers. I will have these linked down below. I would throw over a knit. And I love this knit sweater because it's kind of cropped, so I can tuck it in and it's warm, and I'm like honestly already sweating wearing both of these pieces. So that's a good thing. That's great. I would tie this whole look together with this thrifted Burberry coat. I got this after the dentist one day. I was just walking around and I found this random thrift store and I was just like, thank you. Thrift gods, yes, I will be getting this olive green vintage Burberry coat and I dig it. I feel like now that I have this, I've been noticing so many other people who also have trench coats and I feel like we're in this little club of people who have these and they're so fun to style, both practical and very cute. I would definitely wear some gloves. These I got from Awoke Vintage and I adore them. I love this fit as a going out kind of look, and this is a top that I thrifted. It was originally a dress, but I chopped off the bottom of it. I really love it paired with these high-waisted cheetah pants that I thrifted from Monk Vintage. They are super warm and I love how it contrasts with the top because they are in a similar color palette, so it's kind of fun to have different patterns mixing together, but obviously this would look really good and easy with a black top as well. Amazing earrings that are by Nia Thomas NY, who is my homegirl. Everything that she sells is made by women and people of color and uses recycled materials. I'm obsessed with these, they're so fun. Just don't get them caught in anything because that'll be painful. But yeah, I love these, and my rings that everyone always asks about are from Nia Thomas NY as well. Would throw over a large mock neck knit turtleneck sweater over this. I'm just gonna insert a photo of what I would throw over this as an extra layer. I feel like most YouTubers would just go out and try and find something like that, but I'm like, just imagine it on my body because that would look really cute with this and give me another layer of warmth. And then over that, I would throw on this secondhand vinyl coat, which I got from Beacon's Closet. For shoes, these are some amazing platforms that I came to acquire by the brand Unif. They are insane and super comfortable. I'm wearing this really nice velvet button down that I got at a clothing swap. It's so sweet. Underneath, I just have a little bralette from Net Rose. This little necklace that I'm wearing is from Dalmata. I threw over this amazing Ralph Lauren blazer coat that I got off of Depop and I'm fully obsessed with. It has some little shoulder pads and this really nice belt to kind of cinch in the waist. My friend gave me this little butterfly pin, which I adore, so I just put that right there. My thrifted little purse, and then on the bottom, I'm wearing these Ralph Lauren forest green pants. They are super flattering, and they're also boot cut, so they look great with these heels from Awoke Vintage. Obviously, this blazer alone wouldn't be enough to keep me warm in this New York City winter weather. So I would throw over this huge Fila coat that is ginormous on me to lock in all of that heat and It has a hood for if it starts snowing, raining, hailing, you never really know. I love this and I think that it looks really rad on top. That's just me. It is also super warm. There's some quilting inside of here, a nice little secret pocket. Definitely the most wearable for me. I've been wearing this white turtleneck nonstop, and I traveled all throughout Europe with this turtleneck and these jeans, and they have just become so essential in my wardrobe and just one of my favorite things to throw on. It's really casual and simple. Yeah, this is thrifted from ThredUp. It's super warm, once again, by the brand Brandy Melville, and my pants are also from ThredUp, but they're by the brand Free People. I get a lot of questions about these pants. They do make the booty look good, but they fit a little bit weird. And then I threw over this Marlboro Canon camera bag that is for a film camera. This I got on Depop, and this is such a great bag for going out. I'm sweating in this, which is how you know you'll be warm outside. If you're sweating inside, you'll probably be just right when you go outside. So I actually like to throw this over another turtleneck, like my little gray turtleneck. I would probably wear underneath this and be super insulated, and then on top maybe throw over a black hoodie, and then this Fila jacket. But it actually hasn't gotten that cold yet in New York. It's been 50s, 30s, but it's not freezing yet. The shoes that I paired with this outfit are platform boots by Demonia that I got off of Depop, and I do think this outfit would look so cute with some low-rise white sneakers to give it more of a sporty vibe, but I just think that these boots look way better with the street-like cut of the denim, so that's why I opted for these instead, but I've been loving seeing baggy denim and white sneakers on people lately, but these definitely add more of a grungy element that I also truly, deeply live for. I just can't hang. You can just literally see down my whole backside. Here we are again in my white turtleneck because I do wear this every day. It's so warm, and I just threw it underneath this amazing little cotton slip dress that my friend Mary V thrifted, and then she gave it to me because she didn't want it anymore. And this Marc Jacobs bag that I got for free at an event there, and I just think that it goes with this kind of like icy, ice clean kind of look. And then the final key piece of this whole outfit is this ridiculous faux fur coat by the brand Jackie, and it has a little label on the sleeve so that everyone can see it's free from fur. This was a gift for my 22nd birthday, and it's kind of a more high quality faux fur. It does not release microplastics and can be likened to any synthetic garment that you would wash in your washer, and it only needs to be dry cleaned about once a year. One of the things that I like about Jackie is that they will take back your coat after you're done wearing it and actually recycle it and reuse it, and they'll give you a discount for doing that. Could potentially be one of the most extra, even though it's literally a pair of pajamas. It's this matching pajama set, which I adore. I thrifted this upstate New York a year or so ago, and I just adore the pattern on it and the colors. There's a bunch of little flowers and little hearts, and I love the bottoms that match. They have little buttons on the side, and I just roll them up. There's just something so sweet about having a matching pajama set as an adult that makes you feel super cozy. And on top of this, I'm wearing this scarf that my grandma gave me, which is such an amazing color. And then I'm wearing this little picnic basket material purse. I really don't know what to call this, just like a woven purse. I thrifted this at Beacons. For shoes, I'm wearing these Naked Wolf high top sneakers.